This quick tutorial is to cover today's update to Final Cut, that's 10.4.9. It's a fairly minor update, but there are some interesting features, and we're going to specifically look at the audio crossfade and fade enhancements. I'm Bruce Macbryde, and my goal is to improve your knowledge, speed up your workflow in Final Cut. So please like, subscribe, and press the bell. A couple of things to notice. First of all, it does require an update to libraries so that when you run this new version, the libraries will ask to update. There's some welcome little touches. The icons are a little brighter and slightly different shape. And you'll also notice that some of the menu items are larger. And this is definitely an improvement from my point of view because I've found it hard in the past to see the items in the menus. What we're going to specifically look at is the changes in the audio fades, and there's an automatic crossfade, and then there's also the ability to create your own fades. So let's select a clip with some audio in the timeline, and the new items are in the modify menu and adjust audio fades, and in here we can apply fades, and that will put a fade at the beginning and at the end. And you can remove those by going back here and remove fades. And there are shortcuts here, you'll notice. We can also come in here and we can put a fade in only, that's no fade out, or a fade out only. And so now we've got the fade in and the fade out, but we've done them independently. We can go back here and remove those fades. So the crossfade works on this basis. Select your two clips and to show the edit point there, and then come to the modify menu and select crossfade. Now, visually, we haven't seen anything happen at the moment, but when we expand these clips, you can see there's the crossfade there. Now, the interesting thing about this is that if you've already got a crossfade and you come back to the adjust audio fades, and crossfade is grayed out. So you can check crossfades are there even though the audio is not expanded. Just as a warning, if you do remove the crossfades and then you come back and ask it to fade again, you'll see that it appears that crossfades are in fact still there. So if you check when you expand the clips, then the crossfades have been taken out, but the clips are still overlapping. So if you want to redo a crossfade that's been removed, then you will need to adjust the expanded clips before you can go back to creating a new crossfade. So the crossfade doesn't apply to just one edit point. You can select a number of clips with audio and then come to crossfade, and you'll see that the crossfade has been applied to all of the clips selected. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe.